made huge assumptions that we should be promoting health. That's what our whole health promotion, that's what our field's called. But what if health is not the right hook? When you tell people that they don't have to use exercise as a like weight loss tool, especially a woman, oh, relief. And that relief opens up people to wanting to exercise. You mean I don't have to do it this way that I hate to do and it makes me feel bad about myself? Oh my God. Well then, that opens up all the space. Well, how do I want to do it? And how can it help? We need to help people see what the ROI is for them. Forget about what you care about the ROI, what our bosses care about the ROI, what Obama cares about the ROI. It's what people care about, and we need to teach them that 30 minutes of moving is not about 30 minutes of moving. It's about the other 23 and a half hours in our day. It's when we move more and have more energy and reduce our stress, we enjoy work more. We're more patient parents. We don't snap at our spouses as much, right? I mean, it enhances our whole day. That's the hook. So I got contacted by a physical activity campaign in California, and a woman said to me, you know, Michelle, I really want to get your advice. We're targeting midlife women for exercising, moving 20 minutes a day. What do you think about it? Can you give me your thoughts? Pledge 20. I said, pledge 20? I don't want to pledge 20. I already pledged, you know, 150 for other things. I don't want to pledge 20 minutes a day. I want to celebrate 20, right? We need to change our language and our imagery. We need to hook people. Physical activity, moving our bodies, is a celebration. But we're not talking about it in that way. Think about a house. Would you knowingly purchase a house that had a weak and shaky foundation? No. Well, we are promoting behavior change that's supposed to stand the test of time on foundations that just crumble. So we need to start thinking about behavior as something we want to last a lifetime, and we need to start designing our programs to accommodate those goals. Organizational context. Based on what I'm saying, everyone around this conference is walking around talking about cultures of health, cultures of health. We have to create cultures of health. Is that an optimal message for employees? I would say no, but here's the analogy. Exercise is medicine. This campaign was designed to promote physical activity to clinicians. Great message for clinicians. It's also being used for the end user. Terrible message for the end user. So if we're talking about cultures of health for internal purposes, that's probably a great idea. But if you're talking about cultures of health and health risk assessments, don't even get me started. Yuck! Can't we come up with something that's gonna be more motivating to people to wanna do? And ask the same questions? Because truthfully, the things people care about, feeling good and being happy and having joy and having energy, exercising more and eating healthy and getting more sleep, all of those behaviors lead to the same outcomes. So why aren't we trying to hook individuals with the outcomes that they're gonna be